Okay, and here's our demo. And what we're going to be doing is we're connecting to a server that I've already set up called MinIO 1. So the first thing I need to do if I want to do versioning is I need to create a bucket. So I'm going to do an mcmb, and mcmb is creating a bucket, and I'm going to make this on MinIO 1. And we're going to call it bucket versioned. There we go. Bucket successfully created. Now, the bucket is not versioned right now, believe it or not. It is really just out there. It's completely in an unversioned state. So if I want to turn versioning on, I do an mc version, okay? And enable, to enable it. I could also do suspend, and we'll do that in a little bit. And this is MinIO 1, bucket versioned. There we go. Versioning is now enabled. Very, very simple to do. I could also do this through the console if I wanted to, but I'd rather just do it from the command line. So if I wanted to turn it off, again, I would just use the same command, but I would use suspend instead of enable. Let's go ahead and upload a file. So we're going to do a cp, mccp, and we're going to take sample.txt, which I have locally in my system here, and we're going to upload that to MinIO 1, bucket versioned, and we'll call this versioned.txt. So there we go. I have now uploaded sample text to versioned.txt. If I do an mc, ls, MinIO 1, bucket versioned, what do I see? Well, I see that I have a versioned.txt. No version IDs, no version numbers, though. In order to get the version ID, the version numbers, you explicitly have to say versions. Okay? Make sure that you always put this versions flag on there if you want to see the versions, otherwise you're not going to see them. I only have the one version, which is fine, but notice I've got this version ID 50A7, la 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 la, and version 1 is my version number. So let me go ahead, and at this stage, we're gonna upload the same file a couple more times, and I can just go back in my command list and just do that, easy enough. So there we go. If I do an mcls versions now, well, guess what? I've got three versions because the bucket is actually versioned for me. So there we go. My bucket's versioned. I've got three versions. I've got three unique version IDs. I've got three version numbers, version 1, version 2, version 3, and we're set to go. So if I wanted to get one of these versions, now all the versions are the same, but I can specifically get one of these with mccp. And what I will do is I'm pulling down MinIO 1, bucket versioned, versioned text. And if I don't give it a version ID, it's just going to put it in my local file called local text. But if I want a specific version, I would do dash vid, okay? And after the dash vid, let's get this second one here instead of the first one. And there we go. It pulled down that particular version. Now, there's not really a good way for me to show you that because we just uploaded the same version of the same file three times, but it is pulling down the second version of this. If I want to delete a specific version, I can do an mcrm, MinIO 1, bucket versioned, dot text, and I would give it the same vid. Instead of doing that, let's do mcrm, MinIO 1, bucket versioned, versioned text. And what happens when I do that is it creates this delete marker. Notice that it also told me right there what the version ID is. I can still see that if I do an mcls. And notice now I have a V4 with a version ID that is a delete marker. This DEL indicates that it is a delete marker for me. Notice also that it says 0 bytes. It's not taking up any space. It's just simply there. If I do an mcls now, mcls without versions, it's going to tell me that I don't have anything in the bucket. No response. This is because the last version is that delete. Now, if I do an mcrm bucket versioned and I do a vid of, guess what, my delete marker, now I've removed that version ID. If I do an mcls again, guess what, now it's back. What version is it? It's the latest version, version number 3 of my list. Now, let me go ahead and do an mcrm again, and instead of deleting the delete marker, I'm going to delete version number 2, B28 la 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 la. If I place that right there, what's going to happen? It has now removed it. If I do another MCLS versions, and let me do a clear so we can move this to the top. If I do another MCLS versions, notice my other two version IDs are still there and are still the same, but my version numbers are now 1 and 2. It collapsed from 123 to 12. So that shows us everything that we can do with the versions there. When we list it with the delete markers, the latest version, it's gone. So what else can we do with this? Well, first of all, what I want to do is I want to, one more time, delete this latest version, MCRM, MinIO 1, bucket versioned, versioned.txt. And again, that creates the delete marker. So if I do an ls from versions, I have a delete marker. What happens now if I do a mccp sample text, and we put that up to minio1 bucket versioned.txt, same name. If I do this, it uploads it. What happened to the delete marker though? It's still there. And it's still version 3 right now. So I still have this delete marker. I'm still tracking this delete marker in the system. One other thing I want to show you, I'm going to do an MC version suspend MinIO 1 bucket versioned. Okay, now I've suspended this. I'm going to do that MCCP again. Okay, but what happened when I did this? It created a new version with the null version ID. Check it out. Version 5 here has a null version ID. Okay, so this is important because now if I do another put, let me just do it a couple more times. Because versioning is suspended, let me clear it one more time. Because versioning is suspended, I still only have version 5. Next step, what happens when I do an MC version enable MinIO 1 bucket versioned? Okay, turning it back on now. And now if I upload the same file to the same name again, what do I get? Well, that null version, version 5, is still going to be there. It's still there. So you may be asking yourself, oh man, how do I get rid of this? Well, remember, I said the null version ID is kind of its own unique ID. So I can actually do an MCRM MinIO 1 bucket versioned versioned.txt and give it a VID of null. And when I do that, it removed the version ID null. It's going to collapse the other versions. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Another thing that would happen, I'm not going to show this right now, but another thing that would happen if I turned it off, I uploaded it, I get that null, I turn it back on, I upload it, I get a new version, version 6, version 7, version 8. If I then suspend again for whatever reason, and my null version is, say, version 5 of 8 versions, if I upload it again, it's going to jump to the latest version and it's actually going to replace the old version, okay? So it's still uploading to the same version ID of null whenever I have versioning turned off. And that's the important point there. So we've seen all the things that kind of versioning implies when you're using a versioned bucket, all the things that can happen when you're working with versions. So I hope you've enjoyed this demo and we'll see you for the next video. If you want to reach out to us, you can reach out to us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can connect with us on slack.min.io interactively at any time. That's our public Slack channel. Or you can just add a comment here to the video. Thank you very much. We'll see you for the next one.